WETS-FM went on the air on February 22, 1974. From the very beginning, the driving force behind the station was the manager, Dick Ellis.
Our listeners are the people who put it together. That is, as far as the money is concerned. Our staff, the people who made it happen. No one person could take credit for all of this.
Dick Ellis was the first manager of WETS-FM. He was hired by East Tennessee State University in 1973, while the station was still in the planning stages. Ellis was a native of Roan Mountain, Tennessee. After service in the Navy during the Second World War, Ellis attended Northwestern University in Chicago. Financial considerations brought him home, and he finished his college education at Lees McRae College in Banner Elk, North Carolina. Dick Ellis became well known as a broadcaster in the Tri-Cities region, working for both radio and television. He was well known as a sportscaster.
Smith gives the ball away, and at the line of scrimmage, Randy Pearson is hit. He gets it to the 35. Again, Doug Farst was the first man.
Dick Ellis was probably best known for his character Little Richard, heard every weekday morning on WJCW radio with his longtime partner William Mars, known as Professor Kingfish.
You know, we one time got talking about hybrid animals, you know?
Yeah.
And got talking about a jack and a mare and all this sort of thing, and the cross between them makes a mule, and the mule can't reproduce itself.
That's right.
Although the public knew Ellis generally for his rube character, Little Richard, on commercial radio, his primary broadcasting interest was public radio. From the very beginning, he was determined that WETS-FM would be a different kind of radio station. At first, the station was on the air only 12 hours a day, with mostly classical music. As the broadcast day grew, so did the variety of program offerings. Soon the programming included jazz, then folk music and bluegrass, blues, women's music and information, vintage and alternative rock, Celtic music, and of course, news and public affairs. The broadcast day expanded, first to 18 hours, then to 24 hours a day. In the fall of 1989, WETS-FM moved into its new home. The building is a state-of-the-art design, with studio space allowing live on-air performances and recordings.
As I remember, about $245,000 went into this building alone. And that $245,000, we feel, was wisely spent.
In December of 1991, Dick Ellis was diagnosed with lung cancer. He continued to work as much as possible while undergoing treatment. On January 24, 1993, a ceremony was held at the station to name the building after the man who made it possible. ETSU President Dr. Roy Nix praised Dick's efforts on behalf of the station.
It's been said that this was the best radio station in the country, or in one of the resolutions, a premier station. I think we need to get that out of the way and over with. And to do that, I'd like to read a letter from Governor McWhorter. It says, on behalf of all the citizens of Tennessee, I can congratulate you, Dick Ellis, on the naming of the facility at WETS-FM in your honor. Your 20 years of leadership as the first and only director of WETS-FM have created a public radio station second to none in this country. Thank you for your exemplary service to the state of Tennessee. And again, congratulations upon the naming of Richard F. Ellis Hall. Thank you, Dick Ellis.
Dick Ellis died on February 7, 1993. During his life, Dick Ellis was a man who believed in personal involvement for the betterment of his community. He was involved in many ways, through the Appalachian Fair Board, through Pony League Baseball, and through many other community activities. His biggest legacy to this region, however, remains the radio station to which he devoted so much time and effort. And on behalf of those who knew Dick, who worked with him over the years, who were friends with Dick, we thank him.